In Mutant Year Zero, you actually don't have scenarios in the traditional sense. You don't have a prescribed, predetermined course of events. Instead, you have a number of different tools that you use from as a game master to create the story of the game together with the players. And one of these tools are the threat cards that we discussed in an earlier episode. These are cards that each describe a threat to the Ark, the settlement where you live and where you start the game. Another very important building block or tool in the game are the so-called special zone sectors. As we also described previously, the zone, when you explore it, is divided into a large number of sectors. You can generate the content of these sectors with a few dice rolls, but you also have what's called special zone sectors. These are more advanced and more detailed sectors of the zone, locations, places in the zone. These are described in detail. They have a backstory, they have NPCs, they have things you can find there. There is a map for each of them, and also a number of possible events, things that can occur there. And the cool thing about the special zone sectors is that you can actually place them in any sector that you want on the zone map. So you don't have to force your players to go to this location to find the cool scenario. Actually, you can just place the scenario in front of or wherever your players want to go. So you don't need to force them to follow the adventure. Instead, you can make the campaign follow them. In the next episode of these Dev Diaries, we'll be talking about The Path to Eden, which is the main campaign backstory or meta plot of the game.